if countries use this index wisely and not react to it and not react defensively, there is much to they can learn from it. Even on items that they may not agree with what the index says, they still can learn something about where the world thinks they are with respect to this indicator or that indicator.
I think the index is a very, very good thing and very complementary to the work of the IEA and to WINS.
The 2010 Nuclear Security Summit in Washington, D.C. was a real innovation in terms of getting key governments together to do some real problem solving on a critical issue. What the index, we hope, will do is give them a better and more refined sense of where they're doing well and where there's areas for improvement.
I have no doubt that the index will have a significant impact in the Nuclear Security Summit by providing a basis for performance comparison, which is lacking now, and which will help to focus the discussion at the summit.
So in advance of the summit, what this index will do is it'll help countries come prepared to the summit with what they have been able to do and what they plan to do on various aspects of nuclear material security.
So our hope is that with the 2012 Nuclear Security Summit in Seoul, that governments will be able to look at their country profiles and other pieces of our analysis around the index and really inform themselves on, you know, what would be a very meaningful commitment.
In addition, there are many states that are not part of the Nuclear Security Summit process. And so our index will also provide information to them so that they as well may make commitments in the nuclear material security area.
And then finally, for the set of countries that are able to provide either financial or in-kind assistance, they'll be able to use the index to figure out who to target for that assistance.
As part of the index process, one of the things we will be providing is a country summary. So for each country, there will be a summary that identifies where that country is particularly strong, where it is perhaps average, and where there's room for improvement. On those summaries then provide a means for countries to identify where their focus should be in improving their nuclear material security.
Countries and operators can use that in their own efforts of improving themselves and seeing now what is it that makes a difference. Pieces that can be highlighted, taken on, and made better.
They can look at the ratings that they've gotten and say, gee, we're getting rated down on this point and that point. Maybe we ought to do something about that. And some of those may be things that are difficult for them to change, like, for example, the state of corruption in a country. It may be difficult for that country to change. But other things, it may be quite easy for them to make a decision to go in a particular direction, for example, publishing more information about what their nuclear security regulations are, in order to both build public confidence in their nuclear security arrangements and get a better score on this index.
I would hope that the index would be used in a constructive way, that it would be seen as a helpful tool for those that are dealing with nuclear security. I hope that countries will feel that this is not something that would point fingers, but more be on the constructive, helpful side to visualize the different components of a nuclear security system and how they can be dealt with.